Hi, so my name is Danny Kelly and I'm Head of Innovation at Vodafone UK. So it's evident that technology is going to really change the way we all live and work in our lives. And one area that's changing faster than most is the area of autonomous vehicles, like this one just behind me. Connectivity is key, and we're going to see real advances in the technology adoption through 5G in this area. I'm here at the Celtic Manor in Wales, where just recently some of the world's top golfers were transported from the clubhouse to the first tee in this autonomous vehicle, all powered by Vodafone's superfast network. I'm here with Simon, CTO of Aurrigo, the company that manufactured these amazing vehicles. So Simon, for everybody watching, could you tell us a little bit about this technology?
Yeah, so this is a fully autonomous self-driving vehicle. So to be able to autonomously drive, you have to know where you are, and there's a load of sensors on this vehicle. So we have laser scanners, we have cameras, we measure how fast the wheels are going around. And from all of that information, we build a map of the vehicle as it goes through the space. We can then use that same set of sensors to work out where we are in the map and then drive autonomously.
Fascinating. Shall we go inside and have a look?
Yeah.
So Simon, Vodafone are leading a number of projects across the UK for the advancement of autonomous vehicles onto our roads. But actually, vehicles like this are already in use today. Where else are we using these vehicles?
Yeah, so we have several deployments of these. There's six of these vehicles running around the Science Park in Cambridge. We also have a deployment down at Heathrow Airport. We use Vodafone networks down there where we're moving baggage around using autonomous baggage dollies.
So Vodafone's in the middle of rolling out our 5G network across the country. Super low latency, super high bandwidth. How will that really play into how these autonomous vehicles will work?
You need to have the connectivity, and the connectivity has to have the low latency so you can be monitoring in the loop in real time. You need the high bandwidth because you need video signals and you've got to get that from a vehicle out over your network. If you don't have the low latency and you don't have the high bandwidth, it's really hard to take the humans out of the vehicle.
So do you see a time in the future when we will see a wider deployment of these vehicles, say for example in public transport?
So the movement towards smart cities with connected mobility is driving this autonomous revolution. If you can guarantee the connectivity and you know where all those different vehicles are within that scheme, you can of course then do a connected journey, and you can also make it so that it's a very efficient system to run as a vendor and an operator, so you can make a business case around it.
So just thinking about how 5G plays into that, what we do know is that 5G will effectively give the vehicle a lot more perception of what's around the vehicle. How else will 5G really transform the way in which these vehicles will operate through VDX communication?
You can have a much better seamless use of the built infrastructure that's there already, and the whole V2X mechanism can also give you things like smart communications with traffic lights as well as other signaling systems. So yeah, the 5G is going to really help that, because as well as the other bits of technology, edge compute and so on, all together they give you a ecosystem that allows robots to communicate to each other in a safe way, cyber secure, good uptime, excellent connectivity and reliable.
That is the power of a 5G network. Thanks very much, Simon.
All right, you're welcome.
So I think it's safe to say we'll see many more of these autonomous vehicles on our road soon, and many more advancements from Vodafone 5G. Thanks for watching.